is the KiwiCo Pumpkin Launcher.
Okay.
3, 2, 1!
Whoa! I'm Julia.
And I'm Alex. At KiwiCo, we create projects for you to build at home, which means we have to think big but design small so that everything you need can fit into a box.
We wanted to challenge ourselves to take on something a little bigger, so we're building a pumpkin launcher.
And to make things even more fun, we're turning it into a game.
But first things first, we gotta do some research. So to learn more about different types of launchers, I built the Tinker Crate Trebuchet and the Tinker Crate Ballista. There are our versions of giant catapults that were used on battlefields thousands of years ago. The ballista was the first long-range catapult to use bundles of twisted ropes to throw projectiles. On an ancient ballista, they usually had a crank on the side that they would use to pull back the projectile, but on ours, we just have a simple rope. So when we pull back this rope and release it, it'll shoot the projectile, like this.
Unlike a ballista, a trebuchet used gravity to launch projectiles, kind of like a giant seesaw.
When I add weight to this side, it makes the other end of the arm want to fling this way. So when I release the pin, the projectile goes flying. These catapults were used for some pretty scary stuff back in the day, but they're also really great ways to learn about physics and engineering. I'm really liking a lot of the mechanisms that I learned about while I built these, especially this pin mechanism for releasing the trebuchet. So I'm gonna go talk to Alex and see if we can incorporate any of these ideas into our prototype.
I just finished building a prototype to test out some of our materials and our design plan. The final launcher is going to be 7 times bigger than this one.
We need to build a sturdy wooden frame to support the super strong elastic tubing we're using for the sling. Then we're going to install a crank like a ballista to pull back the sling and a pin mechanism to release it just like a trebuchet.
Now we just have to build it.
You took yours off.
Oh, I thought we were just had to, I didn't know if we did it too early.
First thing we have to do is build the frame.
All right.
Here she is.
It's done.
That's the frame. All right, now we're marking up the other end of the wood that we haven't cut yet, because as they say in construction,
measure twice, cut once.
Unscripted.
We need some giant brackets to support our giant frame, so we're using the laser cutter.
This is wrong. There we go. No, wait, this is wrong. We finished building the frame, so we called in some fellow product designers to help us with the assembly.
You are our human clamps. It's so big!
After we assembled the frame, we did some testing to narrow down our sling design. We tried a bunch of iterations, but we figured a simple canvas basket would work best for our test launch.
This may look like a pumpkin basket, but really, it's a face mask for joy.
We attached the sling to our elastic tubing, which then clipped onto the hooks on our frame. Then we installed the pin release mechanism and attached the clip for the crank.
Test crank number one. Pumpkin.
We're ready for our first real life test, but before we graduate to pumpkins, we're gonna try a test with a soccer ball.
to be exciting regardless of the result.
3, 2, 1,
the ball worked, so it's time to try out a pumpkin.
Who wants to go on the ride?
Let's get a nice medium pumpkin.
Mm-hmm. Perfect. 3, 2, 1.
Double them up. If we just double them over, they're gonna be shorter, and then we'll be getting more power when we're pulling it back.
Double the pumpkin power.
Yeah.
Am I counting? I think we'll count together.
Okay.
3, 2, 1.
That was good.
It went really far, which is great.
Our test launch was a surprising success. We spent the rest of the day making a few small adjustments to the design. Now we're finally ready to take this baby to the pumpkin farm for game day. We've disassembled the launcher so we can load it all up in the truck and take it to the pumpkin farm.
You never know when you're gonna need a small plank of wood.
I think that's everything.
Yeah.
All right, Steve, you're gonna go on a really special ride to a really special place.
All right, you know how to get there, buddy?
We did it, we're here.
We rallied fellow product designers to compete in the launch off. Each team will get 3 tries to hit the target. If your pumpkin lands in the outer ring, that's 25 points. The middle ring gets you 50 points, and a bullseye is 100. If you overshoot, that's 10 points. And of course, bonus points will be awarded for splats. Each turn, players will choose a pumpkin, how much power to launch it with, and a launch angle. There are 4 different hook options, which will determine the pumpkin's launch angle. The angle that the players choose will impact where and how their pumpkin lands. The top hooks will send the pumpkin up high and down hard, but it won't travel very far. Whereas the bottom hooks will send the pumpkin far, but not as high, limiting the chance for splats.
We're Team Orangey Mad, and this is Marcel and Taylor.
What's up? This is Team Purpkin Chirpkin. This is Daniel and Kristen.
You're gonna lose!
Let's play rock, paper, scissors to decide who goes first.
Okay, on 10.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10!
Let's go. I want to go like here, I think.
It's getting tighter.
Yeah. Okay, I think that's good.
I've removed the safety.
Safety's off.
I'm gonna grease it up.
Grease.
Okay. So we're gonna do like a really fast but powerful yank.
Okay.
Got it.
Okay. 3, 2, 1. Get in.
Whoa! Oh! Oh! We're in the lead now.
Yeah, we're in the lead! Woo!
All right, first pumpkin up is the large and flat pumpkin, also affectionately known as discus pumpkin.
Discus pumpkin! Woo! Okay. Also known as disco pumpkin.
Yeah, disco pumpkin, okay. Depending on your mood.
We're going to a slightly lower angle, like 45, more of a straight shot. Cool, would you like to load the pumpkin?
Oh yes.
That sling design, who did it?
All the way with the target.
All the way.
Like, the target.
Might. That'd be fun though.
3, 2, 1. Oh!
Woo!
Woo!
This is points.
50 points.
Let's go.
Now points. We're winning.
T- Taylor's up for gourd selection.
Hmm. This one looks pretty good. It's a nice small one. Let me scratch and sniff. Yep.
Right now we're at a 45 degree. Last time we were at a 60, so we need less power because of that. And this pumpkin's a little bit smaller than last time, so we definitely need less power.
Now. Yeah, I think that's good.
Yeah. All right. Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Oh! Yeah! Woo! Aren't you mad?
That was gorgeous.
Yes. Fine.
This one told me it's a winner.
A little bit farther?
Yeah. 3, 2, 1.
Oh!
Oh!
That's a lot of points.
Yeah. We're behind by 25.
That's fine, we can do that.
Oh, we got this.
Yeah, easy.
So this is our last launch. We don't know what they're gonna end up getting on their last launch, but currently we have a 25-point lead, which is a comfortable margin, but it's not a super comfortable margin. So no. I feel like, I don't know, Marcel, this is your pumpkin, but I'd love to go
to make another splat happen.
Yeah,
another center splat, that's the dream.
Center splat, so 110 points.
Woo.
So less than the first year?
Yeah, let's do it, let's do it.
Okay, because it is a smaller pumpkin.
It's a tiny pumpkin. What's for all the oranges out there?
All the oranges out there.
3, 2, 1. It's fine,
but
it's
fine. It's fine. 20. Yeah. Oh no!
How do we sabotage them?
They're still in the lead, but we have a chance here.
We gotta get more than 45 points. We're gonna win.
I think we can get more than 45 points.
Yeah.
For our last shot, we really had to go with someone we know well, and that's why we settled on Max Danger. Thanks for your sacrifice, Max.
We're behind, so we're thinking that we gotta go big or go home. So we're gonna go with the lowest angle. We're gonna bowl Max Danger, and you know, it could all work out for us.
I don't even know if it's gonna go up, but we have not tested this.
To the metal!
What if it hits the bar?
I know.
A little farther, a little farther.
Farther?
Yeah. Okay.
Ready?
3, 2, 1.
Oh!
My boy!
All right, so it didn't leave the launch zone. Alex, I'm gonna let you rule on this one.
I have confidence in our team.
Go.
Yeah.
3, 2, 1.
Whoa!
Chirpkin, chirpkin!
For the win! For the worm!
For the worm!
I respect what you did out there today, but I regretfully award you this pumpkin.
Yeah!
Woo! Yeah! Yeah! Beautiful.
Chirpkin, chirpkin.
For the win.
For the win.
Thanks so much for following along with our pumpkin launcher build.
If you want to launch things at home, check out KiwiCo.com.
See you next time.